I want to talk with you in this video about how to lead the discussion. There's a fair bit here that I want to say, so then I'll have Dan conclude this little piece here. In leading the small group discussion in your group, you need to have a plan and then work the plan. And here's what we suggest. You begin the meeting with small, friendly conversation with everybody. You know, friendly, small talk, just catching up with the week so that people feel like they have a place to just talk and talk about what's been happening recently. After a few minutes of that, explain then the purpose of the meeting, and that's we're going to continue in this series that we've started together. Now, the small group curriculum that you have will supply you with some suggested questions you can use. So you begin, you watch the teaching video, and then you have some questions. Now, the reason that we give you questions is that it gives you something to focus on and get the group started to talk. So while this is the goal or purpose you have for the meeting, when the conversation does get going, rabbit trails will suddenly come up. Somebody's going to want to take off and talk about this. And you need to allow for that somewhat, because that's what people are thinking about and processing. So allow them to go down the rabbit trail. But you'll need to discern, though, how far down that rabbit trail you go. Because you may recognize, we're getting a little bit too far off the track of what we're trying to do here tonight. So what do? Well, at that point, you just step in and say, friends, you know, this is a really interesting discussion we're getting into, but it's a lot bigger than what we want to can do tonight. Can we hold that question for another time? Then you can gently bring them back into the purpose of the series, which is we're trying to discuss these rules.
Well, we want to encourage you to not feel pressure to be the teacher. Just ask questions. This is not really a teaching time. Your goal as a small group facilitator is to get people talking, and you help facilitate this. Therefore, we say no question is out of order. No honest question is to be judged as inappropriate. And here's another piece to take the pressure off of you. You don't have to answer every question. Remember, the point of these groups is to get people talking and dialoguing, because the questions and the answers will kind of show up in the dialogue. So it's okay to let questions hang in the air. Resist the temptation to quickly answer a question. A question comes up, say to the group, well, that's a good question. What do you think? You may have an answer in your head. Don't say it. Let other people say it. Let the group answer.
That's so important, because too often the group leader wants to answer all the questions. Don't do that. Jesus didn't do that. His disciples said, I didn't get your story. He said, oh, you didn't get that story? Well, I'll tell you another story. And he let them hash it out. Well, do it like that.